do, I guess. But what you really should have been upset about was when Trump called Erdogan in Turkey to congratulate him on passing the constitutional amendment that stripped the media and his opposition of basic rights. That's a bummer that didn't have to be made. So all around the world, you see this creeping towards authoritarianism in our foreign policy. Number two is the way we're backing away from international democratic organizations, whether it's NATO or, you know, the Brexit vote on EU, you know, collective government, which makes me a globalist, I understand, is one way to make sure that people have a voice and freedom. And number three, you know, Trump keeps saying these things like, when we talk about Kim Jong-un, probably he's a strong leader, he's a great guy. His country loves him. I'll tell you what, he walks down, you know, people, they sit up straight, right? I wish my people did that. And he's made a number of comments like that, like when he said that it was, I believe, treasonous that we did not stand and applaud him as often as Pope said. And he also, in fact, oh, come on, he was just kidding. Because, you know, fascism just never stops being funny. It's a real problem that never have we had a government that doesn't allow the media access the way Trump does. Okay? And they are doing all this kind of stuff behind closed doors. It is a threat, and it's something that we need to talk about openly and confront. I also thank you. And